So there's a guy who's reacting to one of my videos, and he identifies himself as, are you ready for this? He calls himself Prolly the Antichrist. Prolly the Antichrist. I'm thinking he's probably not the Antichrist. But anyway, here's what he does. He watches my video and he reacts to it. And now I'm going to react to his reactions to my video. Did you follow all that? You'll follow it. Just take a look.
If God is good, and if God is powerful, then why does God allow so much suffering?
Ooh, this should be a good one.
All the suffering in the planet. Why does God allow it?
I've been asking myself that for a while now.
Here's a very good answer to that.
Doubt it.
So God allows it for a very important purpose. What's he doing here? What's this all about? Why did he create a universe? Why did he do anything? He created a universe to create beings, people, us, so that we could know him, so that we could know his love, his grace, and his mercy. But to show love and grace and mercy in their depth, well, he needed some fallen people who need grace and who need mercy. So he allowed the fall. As soon as you allow the fall, now you have fallen people on a planet and they hurt one another. And there's a lot of pain and there's a lot of suffering.
Wait. Hold on. If the goal is to know God's love, grace, and mercy, and the only way to do that is by being fallen people who need God's love, grace, and mercy, then why do we need cancer? What about disease? Why do we need that? And famine? Why do we need that?
At what point are these necessary to better understand God's love?
Good question. And the answer is all those things came as a result of our rebellion against God. They all came as a result of our fall. And natural disasters and the like are God's way of punctuating, of accentuating how terrible it is, the thing that we did. Like, you can't live in paradise anymore. It wouldn't be right of me to just let you go on living in luxury and beauty and all that. No, you have to realize the severity of what you did. You rebelled against the true and living God. Boom, things change on the planet.
Don't let suffering turn you away from the living God.
So let me see if I understand. God allows suffering so that we can better know him. And the only way to better know him is by God sending his son to take on the sins of the world?
None of this answers why God allows the suffering that he does. Do we really need all the terrors that this world holds just to better understand God?
Do we really need someone to be unplugged and take on the sins of the world to better understand God? This God is a terrible designer. Weak. And if he's going to force us to be fallen, we might as well own it.
So God doesn't force us to be fallen. We choose to be fallen. And God opens a way of redemption for us through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But God does have many purposes for human suffering, one of which is, well, to quote the great C.S. Lewis, pain, suffering is God's megaphone to rouse a deaf world. And so we can hope that your pain, your suffering will cause you to turn to the true and living God.